Let's all play What's My Line? And now, let's meet this week's What's My Line panel. First, he's got a funny side, a sunny side, a laugh for all occasion. Heads or tails will get you Soupy Sales.
Thank you. Thank you, and thank you, Johnny Olson. Right now, here's the young lady. That's the big star of the big hit Broadway show of the season, On the Town. Would you please welcome Phyllis Newman?
Thank you. And here's the handsome star and talented host of Hollywood Squares, Mr. Peter Marshall.
I'm in love. Deeply in love.
Thank you.
Arlene Francis.
Well, now everybody knows. You met two of the happiness boys, Soupy and Peter. Now here's the happiest of the happiness boys, Wally Bruner.
There for a moment, I thought Peter was looking at the monitor during the introduction.
No, I can't stand overbites, Wally.
No, I'm kidding. You're a good group, and welcome everyone to What's My Line. We're going to have fun the next 30 minutes with some rather unusual people and rather different occupations, right?
Ready.
So let's begin. Will our first challenger enter and sign in, please? Burr Sebring. Mr. Sebring, where are you from?
Barrington, Rhode Island.
It's the whole population. Hey.
Well, Burr Sebring is a designer for the Gorham Company. And he recently designed something unusual in sterling silver. Come on, let's hear it. There we go, all right. Now let's show the audience what that new silver item is. So I'll remind you again that Burr Sebring is a designer for the Gorham Company who make things like La Scala, which is a lovely pattern.
Yes.
But I'm kidding. But nonetheless, it's a new silver item. You must find out what it is, and we'll begin with Phyllis Newman.
Thank you. Mr. Sebring, can I rule out ordinary flatware, forks, knives, and spoons?
Yes.
May I rule out dishes and compotes, nut dishes? Thank you.
You're nut dishes.
May I rule out myself? No. Is this something that has never, ever been done in silver before? Not never, ever, but it's something
not
you don't...
Not to our knowledge.
Not to your knowledge. Is it something that I could hold in the palm of my dainty hand?
Yes.
If I held it in the palm of my dainty hand, would its primary function be for me or other people to look at? Rather than a useful... I mean, I wouldn't scoop out...
No, all right, now, you ask a question... Wait just a minute. Okay. Would its primary purpose be for people to look at? No.
No.
One down. Peter.
Well, you see.
It's a workable item. I mean, it's useful.
It's a workable item.
Yes, and you could, is it a kind of a thing that you could play with?
Yes.
Yes. Oh, could it be in the toy department?
Yes.
Is it a, is it F.O.A. Schwartz? No, or F.A.O. or whatever it is. I'm from California. Is it, it's a toy of some kind, in other words.
Yes.
Is a silver toy. Now we have to find out what kind of a toy it is.
That's right.
I'll pass.
Arlene.
Is it a toy that an adult might use?
Yes.
Is it a silver yo-yo?
It is.
There you go. And that's why I passed.
You saw that.
But the Gorham Company has come out with a silver yo-yo.
Why?
That's what I want to know.
Well, we needed a new, inexpensive, sterling item, sterling gift, and my son Peter was playing with his yo-yo one day, playing around with it, and I just thought it might be a good idea to see the thing in silver.
Did you design it?
Yes.
You designed it. Well, now, how does it compare with an ordinary everyday yo-yo as far as its, you know, how it works?
Actually, it's the same size, same shape. It does the same tricks. The experts tell me it
works out quite well. Could we see? You have one here? Could you show us one?
Wally, as a matter of fact, I have one with your initials on it.
A monogrammed yo-yo.
Oh, that is chic.
Look at that.
It's pretty.
Now, if I get the angle just right, you can see the monogram. Can we see the monogram, Artie? Okay, so I have the right angle, and there it is. And what pattern is this? This isn't La Scala. This is Ripoll.
Well, this is a traditional type sterling ornament that we use on a lot of things.
But just so the panel won't be disappointed, I understand they also have monogram.
Oh, they
certainly do.
Well, very good. Well, now, Burr, I got to try this and just see how it works. Let's see. Hey, look at that. Around the world. Come on. Around the world. Over the plane. Burr, thank you.
I do.
It's a very nice gift, and you're delightful to have on What's My Line.
Thank you.
Just say goodbye to the group.
Oh, my
yo-yo.
What's My Line will continue right after this word. Now, another challenger. So will you enter and sign in, please? James Collins. Mr. Collins, where are you from?
Los Angeles.
All right, panel. Jim Collins is in the business of selling an American product in Hamburg, Germany. And now let's show the audience what it is he's selling to the Germans. So it's an American product he's selling in Germany, and we'll begin with Arlene.
Well, it's not the American flag. I can rule that out. Is it in any way decorative?
No.
One down, Soupy.
Is it anything edible?
Yes.
Naturally, it's edible. Is it something that you might enjoy for lunch or dinner?
Yes.
Would it be, you sell it where?
In Germany.
In Germany.
In Germany.
Not too many jokes about that.
That's right. I'm not messing with anything. In Hamburg.
It's a half-hour show, Soupy.
That's right. I'd like to be the first guest. I think it's a food. Is it the kind of? Is it a food that you would find that's very big here in America?
Yes.
Would it be hamburgers?
No.
Two down, Phyllis.
Is it? I had an idea, but maybe I'm wrong. I thought that it might be something that was almost one would think of as German in origin. I mean, like sausage.
Is
or
it sausage?
Hot dog.
No, three down, Peter.
It's not a hamburger and it's not a sausage.
That's right.
It's a typical American kind of a.
Well, it's something we know about here.
Yeah, something we know that they. Soupy, please.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I've got the spotlight.
You're right.
And I'm sick about it. Yes, that's what I was going to check on.
Are you having a conference over there?
No, we weren't. We were flirting is what we were doing. Now, edible, is it, can you drink this?
Four down, Arlene.
Is it animal rather than vegetable or mineral?
Yes.
Is it a combination of things rather than just one kind of meat?
No.
No. Five down, Soupy.
Wait a minute. Did someone say hot dog?
You said yes. Hot dog, not hot.
Are you having a conference again?
No.
Why are you turning on us?
Because I think you're all cheating over
there. No, we're not.
You have 15 seconds.
50. Well, I'll pass because I said hamburgers in Hamburg, Germany, and it's not. Do you have any idea?
It's a meat of some sort.
Yes.
And it's a pure meat, you said, not a processed meat.
Yes.
Is it come from a cow?
No.
Six down, Peter.
I hope it doesn't come from a horse.
I'm gonna flip all the.
Hey, chicken.
It's Kentucky Fried Chicken. But it isn't. Colonel Sanders is big in Hamburg.
Yes, that's right.
Colonel Sanders, Kentucky Fried Chicken. But Jim is one of the foremost, how do I say this, franchisees?
That's what they say.
Franchisees. I don't think I spelled it correctly.
Yeah.
Of Kentucky Fried Chicken and is the president of Collins Food International. Now, how do the people of Hamburg like the Kentucky Fried Chicken?
They like the chicken. I think that it's an educational process because they're not used to the take-home part of the business. And also, I believe the language thing has really made a difference over there.
Well, what's the German name for it?
Oh, I can't.
You own it over there. Yeah, I know. What are you going to tell a cab driver when you want to go there? It's very difficult.
Yeah, it is. It is tough. I don't speak German, and I wish I did. I was just over there.
Well, now, what is your company worth today? I understand it's fantastic.
Well, we're a public company now. We have about $50 million in sales, and we have chicken stores in Los Angeles, Texas, Florida, Australia, and Germany.
Australia, too?
Yes.
How did you get started, Jim?
Oh, I started frying hamburgers for 19 cents back in 1952 and just kind of went up from there.
You once operated your own hamburger stand?
Well, for a long time. And then in number two and number three and number four, and then I met Colonel Sanders one day.
Well, you know, we've had Colonel Sanders on the show, too, within the last year or so. But and everything went, and now you're a $50 million public corporation.
Yes. Huh?
Well, it's a great success story, and we're delighted you could join us.
Did you bring us any chicken?
Yes.
Oh, good.
Would you say goodbye, Jim? What's My Line? We'll continue right after this word. Okay, funsters, blindfolds in place, please.
Funsters.
Because it's time to meet our mystery celebrity guest, and I see you're well blinded, so I'm going to say, mystery challenger, won't you enter and sign in, please? All right, panel, one question at a time. 3 minutes to try and establish the identity of our mystery guest, and we'll begin with Soupy Sales.
Thank you. Well, is it safe to say or ask you, are you not associated with show business?
Yes.
Phyllis.
Yes, he's not.
That's right.
Are you in the sports world?
Yes.
Peter.
Are you in a contact sport?
Yes, I am.
Arlene.
In a contact sport, is it, does it take place indoors?
Well, no.
But it could, well, sometimes. Yeah. Soupy.
All right, is the sport football?
Well, ever see that indoors.
Phyllis.
Is it baseball?
Oh, no.
Peter.
I'll bet it's boxing.
Sometime.
Arlene, it is boxing.
Is it, is it Muhammad Ali?
Soupy?
It's got to be the world heavyweight champion, Joe Frazier.
It is. You're not a bad-looking guy. You know, you don't look like you're too bad. You think I'm going to say anything bad about him, you're out of your mind. How you been, Joe?
Just fine, just fine. I got slightly a little weasel in the throat from singing, you know.
Yeah, you got a group. Well, how come you called them the Knockouts?
Well, imagine I'm associated with boxing, you know, and we've been together, let's say, about maybe 5-6 years now, you know. So the name just popped up in the mind, the Knockouts, you know.
Yeah. It's a rock group, isn't it?
It's a rock group, right? We play a little everything, jazz, rock, you know, country, western.
What? You know how he broke his leg, his ankle, singing with the Knockouts. Did you know that?
Is that
you
true?
Did, Joe? Yeah, that was in Caesar's Palace.
Yeah,
right?
I remember that.
How'd you do that?
Well, I had little tricks on the stage, you know, I usually perform, and somehow my ankle got from under me, you know.
And you really broke it?
I did.
Yeah. That just goes to show you, you know, show business is pretty tough business to be in, Joe.
Safer in the ring.
You better stay back in the ring.
Believe me, I think that show business is twice time as hard as boxing. Because boxing is something you only have, like, maybe 2 to 3 guys you have to contend with. But when you have a band, that's it, like maybe 12, 13 guys, you know. One mistake by one of the guys goofed up the whole thing.
Yeah, but can't you keep them in line a little bit, you know?
Yeah, well, they get out of hand, you know. You can't, let's say, disappoint all of them one time, you know.
Could I ask you a question, Joe?
Sure.
Because we've done shows
if it's 10 seconds long.
Yeah. How old were you when you decided that you wanted to be a fighter?
Let's see, I started about 16 years old.
Yes. Yeah. You know, we're very proud of you.
Thank you kindly.
And we think you're a great heavyweight champion.
Thank you, Mark.
Joe? Thank you.
Joe
Frank. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. What's My Line will continue right after this word. Well, this is one of those unusual programs when we have time for yet another contestant.
Terrific.
So, may I say, will you enter and sign in, please? Percy? Armor. And is it Miss or Mrs.?
Mrs.
Sorry, fellas. Where are you from, Mrs. Armour?
New Rochelle, New York.
All right, panel. Percy Armour works for a non-profit organization. Now, she performs a service. Let's show the audience what her line is. We'll begin with Peter Marshall.
Would it be a type of service that I myself might be interested in?
You might.
Mm-hmm. But I doubt if it's a sort of a thing, a personal type of service that you could use, Peter. So you may be interested in it, but I doubt if you could use it, okay? One down, Arlene.
I wanted to ask you.
No pun intended.
No. I was going to ask if she was an undercover girl, but I didn't really mean that. Do you work for some branch of a government?
Yes.
Would it be in any way, any part of the police department?
No.
Two down, Soupy.
Boy, that really, I thought maybe you probably did. It's a non-profit, not the police department. Would you work for the Internal Revenue?
No.
Three down, Phyllis.
Anything to do with judicial or health services?
Yes.
Yes.
Health services? No.
Peter?
Judicial.
Judicial.
I never asked
it
right.
Let me see. Would you... No, she couldn't.
No conferences.
All right. Are you a judge?
No.
Five down, Arlene.
She's, Do you ever work in a court?
Yes.
Would you be a court secretary?
Meaning? I don't think there's such a title.
Well, you know, stenographer that does the tapping out of what people are saying.
Oh, you mean you're trying
court
to say...
Stenographer,
court
stenographer, yes.
Court reporter. Is that what you're trying to say?
I don't know what I'm trying
to say. Try court reporter.
I'll try it. Are you a court reporter?
That's right. But a stenotypist or a court reporter.
Yes, I didn't know how you said it.
But Percy is a freelance court reporter and is currently on the list. I don't know if that's good or bad. Currently on the list for the Supreme Court for the 9th Judicial District.
It's better than being on the lam.
Does that mean that you're on call or something?
Yes, I am.
And, well, what does a court reporter really do?
A court reporter takes down on a stenograph machine all the proceedings that transpire in the courtroom.
I see. You ever get distracted and, you know, get so involved listening you forget to write?
No, you're somewhat in a subconscious state. You know, you're taking down what's going on, but yet you're not really thinking about it.
Well, did you ever look at one of those tapes when they... Yes, how do you read that stuff after you write it?
Well, you have special training, 2 years at a court reporting school, which, well, most of them are located here in New York City.
You know, it's a double training thing, too.
First, and you never look down. Do you?
No, you can't. You couldn't do it that way.
First they teach you to write it, and then you have to have a separate course, and they have to teach you how to read it.
Yeah.
Or something like that. But it's very complicated. Well, Percy, I'm afraid we didn't stump the panel, but you're a delightful guest on What's My Line, so thank you very much.
Thank you.
Could you say goodbye? You know, that's almost enough to want to go to court for, isn't it? But it's an interesting job, and it does really take 2 years to learn the stenotype thing. So that's a complicated thing. And I just have 30 more seconds, and then we're going to say goodbye. But I'll never let it be said that I could not fill 30 seconds on any day of the week by saying what a delightful and wonderful panel we've had today. And that means only that we are going to invite them to join us again tomorrow, which I hope you'll be able to do also on What's My Life? Prizes or product mentions were furnished and or paid for by the manufacturers or suppliers of the products or services identified.